continuing his search to fill an important post in his administration, National Security Advisor.
Yeah, the White House says the president will speak with at least four candidates for the position. And as Vice President Pence continues his trip through Europe, the president is also expected to speak with three foreign leaders by phone today.
Now, this comes as the administration works to keep one of the president's biggest campaign promises, the repeal and replace of Obamacare. Now, President Trump is promising a new plan in just a few weeks. Now, the president may also get a boost in momentum, possibly, after that appearance at a campaign rally in Melbourne, Florida. The police department there said he was greeted by an estimated 9,000 people, and First Lady Melania Trump also made an appearance.
The America we envision is one that works for all Americans, and where all Americans can work and succeed. A nation committed to a greater civility and unity between people from all sides of the political divide.
Meanwhile,
I came out here today because my family immigrated here from Colombia, South America, and a lot of the freedoms that I believe in personally, a lot of the things that I believe in personally are under attack right now.
Voices of concern, meanwhile, from immigrants living in the U.S. after the Trump administration moves to refine its aggressive new immigration policy. CNN has obtained memos from the Homeland Security Department outlining new guidance that gives federal agents more power to make arrests of undocumented immigrants not on their target list. It also aims to end catch-and-release policies, ultimately making it harder for immigrants to seek refuge. Let's talk about it with CNN political commentator Alice Stewart and former chairman of Washington, D.C.'s Democratic Party, Scott Bolden. Thank you both so much for being with us.
Good morning.
Good morning. Before we get to the immigration policy, I wanted to ask you about the rally in Florida last night. We heard there from Melania Trump speaking to a very seemingly broad audience. But when it comes to Donald Trump, he still seems to be speaking to his base only. How do you think he's going to be able to speak to the rest of the country and try to unify divided Americans?
In my view, he was speaking to all Americans. Look, he was there talking about what he's going to do to create jobs, what he will do to keep our streets safe, what he will do to secure our borders, what he will do to provide quality, affordable health care, and to make the environment better with regard to reducing federal government regulations, which really put a difficult strain on businesses and corporations to create jobs. And all of that in and of itself, that speaks to all Americans. All Americans want those things. And I think that was a good opportunity for him to address the concerns of all Americans. And also, by doing this, it was his way of getting the message directly to the people, getting it right out without the filter of the press, without the filter of the media, speaking directly to the people in a positive atmosphere. It was a very good night in terms of him getting the message directly to the people.
Hey, Scott, speaking about messages, the economic message is very good for Donald Trump. We're seeing records set on Wall Street. We're seeing great numbers coming in. This is what people cared about.
Well, they cared about it, but he was delivered these economic messages and these economic results by Barack Obama. He inherited a terrific economy compared to what Barack Obama inherited. And so the stock market going up and all these other economic indicators is what Barack Obama delivered to him. And so the economic message is clear, but the challenge is, can all Americans benefit from this new economy? Because that is what the criticisms of Republicans were of the Democratic economy, and the people who voted for Donald Trump, was that all of them had not benefited. We'll have to see. Donald Trump still hasn't proven himself with his very supporters who put him in office, because they're economically left behind.
Okay, I want to get to the immigration policy that I was just referring to. Alice, President Trump's new immigration steps, it seems. There is a portion of it that seems a bit contradictory. I want to listen to what the president said addressing DACA in his press conference. Let's listen.
We're going to show great heart. DACA is a very, very difficult subject for me, I will tell you. To me, it's one of the most difficult subjects I have, because you have these incredible kids, in many cases, not in all cases. In some of the cases, they're having DACA and they're gang members and they're drug dealers too. But you have some absolutely incredible kids, I would say mostly, They were brought here in such a way. It's a very, very tough subject. We are going to deal with DACA with heart.
All right, so we have that. Then we have the new immigration policy, which states, quote, the department no longer will exempt classes or categories of removable aliens from potential enforcement. It seems to imply that those protected by DACA are still vulnerable. Are they intact? Are they not, Alice?
Chrissy, what's important to keep in mind with this memo, it's a draft memo, and the White House says it is still being reviewed and some changes may be made based on how the legal team at the White House views this, and that's critical to remember. But also at the same time, you also have to remember over the last 8 years over the Obama administration, they have gone from enforcing existing immigration laws to a more lenient immigration policy. President Trump does not want that. He wants to enforce existing laws, and that includes dealing with all illegal immigrants, not just criminal illegals that President Obama dealt with, but all illegals. And that is, it's difficult and it is hard to deal with when we're talking about children of illegal immigrants, but it's critical as the first step and a key component of his immigration policy and securing the border is enforcing the existing laws. This is a good first step. Once again, this is a draft proposal in terms of putting the issues out on the table, but this is a good first step. We all have to realize that he campaigned on this key issue, immigration and securing the border, and this is exactly what he's doing.
So, Scott, according to ICE officials, 75% of last week's deportation raids, which resulted in 700 arrests, dealt with people who had prior criminal records. So is it possible that its crackdown policy might be working?
What of the 25%, though? What of that 25%? Listen, with Donald Trump and his policies, high priority, all illegal immigrants are high priority. Under Barack Obama, he had high priority and low priority, and quite frankly, many of his critics in the Hispanic community and immigration community called him the deporter in chief. And so, but here, the biggest difference is that Donald Trump, everyone's a high priority. DACA, students involved in DACA, folks here who are seeking asylum, watch the implementation of this draft. It may be a draft, it'll be fine-tuned, but this is the goal and objective of this new administration, and look for it to be challenged in court, because the leeway giving to these immigration officers is unprecedented, quite frankly. And the ability to remove illegal immigrants with or without a hearing is going to be exacerbated in a way that we've never seen before, because immigration, illegal immigration, and removing people from this country is a high priority. It's wrong, it's illegal, and the courts are going to have to intervene. Watch for lawsuits to flow.
Okay, I only have a couple of seconds left here, but I want to get this in regarding the border wall. This was a big issue for so many people. I want to listen to some reporting that CNN has been able to clarify. Let's listen here about the future of the fence.
The latest plans involve adding 177 new miles of fencing and replacing 272 miles of already built fence, according to one high-level source with knowledge of the project. That means the total barrier between the United States and Mexico would cover 831 total miles of a nearly 2,000-mile border. Still, not even half, according to these sources.
So it's moved from a wall to a fence. It's covering less territory than was promised earlier. Alice, will his supporters find this acceptable?
I think everyone across America would agree that Donald Trump is 100% committed to national security and securing the border, whether it's a wall, whether it's a fence. The bottom line is he's going to secure the border and he's going to make this country safe. Look, the issue is about keeping illegals from coming into this country. That's the top priority. The method in which it's carried out is not important. The issue is keeping our nation safe.
Scott, Chrissy,
I think it's a cost reality. It's a campaign promise. It's a paper tiger. It can't be done. And even if you covered the 2,000-mile border, does anybody on this show or in America believe that you're going to stop people wanting to come to America to seek the American dream? I think not. We need a comprehensive immigration policy that's fair to all of us.
Alice Stewart, Scott Bolden, A. Scott Bolden, I should say. Thank you all so much for being here.
Thank you.
Thanks, Chrissy.
Sure.
It's important to remember the president throughout the campaign, even as president-elect, corrected people saying it's a wall,
it's
not a
wall.
Fence. This is rebar and steel. and has criticized the fence because it is just that. We'll see what the legislation is when it is written. Now let's turn to